The Star Wars Special Editions aren't exactly something I think should have ever happened, which could be a video in and of itself. And while I appreciate the experience I had seeing the Special Editions in theaters as a 10-year-old, to be honest, nothing really trumps the original prints of the original Star Wars trilogy. For a lot of folks, the Special Editions aren't a big deal at all, and in fact have welcome changes that people believe helped flesh out George Lucas's vision. Now, I can admit that the sharper image quality and the cleaned up motion control in some areas of the films look fantastic, but I dislike most of the newly inserted scenes that either stretch out the runtime or completely remove what existed before. And out of all of these changes made to the original trilogy, one sticks out as the worst change ever made to the original trilogy period. And this, my friends, is the inclusion and creation of Jedi Rocks over the original space funk jam, Lopty Neck. This complete lifting and replacement of that original scene is a crime. So why is this the worst change out of everything else in the special editions? Well, I have a couple reasons as to why. First, the original song Lopty Neck is a great companion to the Cantina song, with its familiar yet otherworldly vibe. It's also, as I said, this short, funky song, but with this crustiness about it that feels right at home in Jabba's palace. It's got that right dark vibe. And the singer, Cy Snoodles, is one of the coolest, weirdest, idiosyncratic aliens designed for the entire saga. She's like a stretched out frog, and maybe she smoked way too many death sticks, and I think it's perfect. It also doesn't overtake the scene itself. It just adds to the tapestry of Jabba's palace, and it just adds to all that Star Warsiness. If you are a longtime sub to this channel, then you know I have an affinity with puppets, and maybe that's concerning. But creating the Cy Snoodle puppet took months and months of preparation, and ended up being regarded as one of the best practical effects of its time. And that makes sense, knowing that it was a creation of Jim Henson and his team that made this all come to life. But all that hard work, those accolades for top-tier practical effects, the people involved in crafting a song and creating one of the most interesting puppets ever, literally tossed aside in favor for a horrible, overly produced CGI festival. And I can't stress enough how bad this idea was. In my honest opinion, Jedi Rocks ruins the scene itself because it ends up overshadowing everything when the original intent was for Max Rebo's band to just kind of be there in the background, this grungy, dirty band. Adding to that, as I said, the song itself is terrible. It's like something straight out of the holiday special. What used to be that weird space funk Prince-esque music is now a glorified pop jazz number, like one out of an animated Disney movie, with two goofy CGI aliens singing alongside practical elements that absolutely don't mesh together. Not only is the song atrocious, but the visual effects work in the special editions to make both of these new elements come together never happened, and it looks worse. I really do think that replacing Lopty Neck with Jedi Rocks and leaving that as the official print only is kinda disrespectful to the entire team that worked so hard to make Return of the Jedi what it is. Now, I understand that George Lucas ran the show back then, but Star Wars is more than just one man's creation. So much of what made Star Wars what it is were its practical effects and how these teams of people would figure out these brand new ways to bring things to life like we have never ever seen before. As a kid, watching Cy Snoodles move around was terrifying, but captivating. Now, as an adult, when Cy Snoodles comes on in the special editions, I just have a panic attack because I'm about to hear the worst jazz fusion pop song ever written for the big screen. Now, for those who love Jedi Rocks, I guess whatever, that's fine, you can love it. But I highly suggest you at least get your hands on the despecialized version of Return of the Jedi and experience it as originally intended. Lopty Neck is the only song, in my humble opinion, that belongs in Jabba's palace. Like I said, it's the perfect grungy inclusion to that diegetic Star Wars music that makes Star Wars what it is. And to say otherwise
makes you a fake fan.
No, I'm sorry. I'm just kidding. And that does it for today's extremely quick video on why Jedi Rocks is absolutely the worst addition to Star Wars, period. I'm curious if you feel the same way about the song or scene, or maybe you think there is another special edition addition that's far worse, or maybe you think I'm stupid for not liking Jedi Rocks, and it's a masterpiece, and I should quit my channel. Either way, thanks for watching, and AT-AT is signing off.